Hey there, Creatorpreneurs. Welcome to another Tutorial Tuesday on using the Graphics Creator by Laughingbird Software. My name is Mark Sylvester, and today we're going to learn two tricks. One is how to create a reflection effect, and the other, I'm going to teach you how to save your graphics correctly into separate folders. So let's get started. Okay, for my first trick, I'm going to teach you how to create a reflection effect. So we're going to pick a template. It kind of doesn't matter which template you want. I mean, which template you're going to use. So let's just grab any template. I'm going to click this one. And when it launches, for this particular graphic, I'm not going to use the rocket or the smoke effect or probably even this. I'm going to make the canvas a little bit wider, and I'm going to make it pretty big. Then I'm going to come up here to the Photos and Videos tab, and I'm going to type in Canada. So I can show you, see if I can get some water, mountains with some water or something. Oh, look at that. Perfect. Okay, so I'm going to drag this picture over. I'm going to make it fill the canvas, and I'll bring it to the back. Okay, I don't need this, but I'm going to keep it for a little bit. Okay, so we have the word entrepreneur, so we're going to double-click it, and I'll say Canada, I guess, right? And let's make it fairly big. So there's my word Canada. I'm going to click this to make that go away. I don't want the outline. You can see the outline there. I don't want that. I'm going to take off the outline. Make it just a tad bigger. Okay, now to create a reflection, we're gonna do two things. I'm going to duplicate the text, okay? So it's the same text, but then I'm also going to flip it upside down by grabbing this handle and just flipping it, all right? And there's the first part of the reflection. Now we have to make it fade. Now you can do a couple of things. You can do a text opacity and bring it down like that. And it kind of works, right? This is an ice lake or something, kind of cool. All right, or I have somewhere around this video, if you're watching the video on YouTube, it'll be in the description. If you're watching it on Facebook, you'll have it. I'll have it in the comments section. Look around, there's a zip file that contains three or four transparencies that I've created for this tutorial. I have these faded transparencies. When you drag an image over text, you can fill the text with an image. I've created a transparency that gradiates from white to transparent. So let's take the one that says upside down because our word is upside down. And I'm going to click and drag it right over the text. Okay? So now instead of text opacity, it's going to fade from top to bottom. So I'm going to go over to the text color and I'm going to mess around with the width slider here. And you'll notice that I can kind of manipulate the transparency a little bit. Okay, so I'm going to go right about there. And now I'm going to take the opacity and I'm going to make it a little bit less harsh. And there is our cool reflection in a couple of minutes. And now let's do, let's say, welcome to Canada. There is a really cool poster. Now this reflection is a little light, so let's bring it back up. Oops, go back to color and bring the opacity up a little bit more. Cool. In about 2 minutes, have a great looking poster, great Facebook post. There you go. Okay, so the main thing I wanted to teach you about this week in this Tutorial Tuesday video is to say how to save your graphics correctly. I notice a lot of people, when I watch them work in the software, they're not saving correctly. Now here are some things in saving your graphic that you may not have known. So the first thing I want to do, of course, is save. So File, Save As. We're going to call this Canada 1, okay? Call it whatever you want. Now, you'll notice that this is empty. The first time you use it, it's going to be blank. So I'm going to call this Canada Images, okay? And I'm going to hit Save. And then it's saved. Now when I go back to select my designs, you'll notice I have a category that says Canada Images, okay? Easy. Now I click it and it pops back up. Okay, So that's easy. Now, let's say I'm working for a client and he wants three or four different designs. Okay, let's say he wants the word welcome to be white. Whoops, to be white. And the word Canada, let's say he wants that, let's pick up a color from the mountains. So if I use this color picker tool, I can click it and we'll pick up some of the Canada mountains here maybe, or the green. Eh, a little too light. How about the blue? Blue snow. All right, there we go. So let's say he wants a different iteration of the graphic. So now we're gonna save it into the same Canada folder like this. We're gonna save as, we're gonna call this Canada 2, okay? And then this little arrow, click it, and you're gonna see your first folder you created. So I'm gonna click there, and I'm gonna save it. And now when you go back, you're gonna have your Canada images, right? And you're gonna have the second iteration. So let's say he wants another one. You can just keep making different colors or maybe even a different background. So let's say we want this to be yellow this time, okay? And the word welcome, he wants it to be bigger. All right, that kind of thing. Save as 3. And I'm gonna find it into that. Okay, and when I go back, I have 3, and you can have 4, 5, 10, 12, whatever. Now watch this trick, okay? So let's click on one of the images here. Now let's say I have a different image. So let's get rid of the Canadian image here. Go back to photos and we'll pick Paris. Okay. And we'll find a good Paris image. There, that's good. Okay. Bring it down. All right, and now we don't need the reflection on this particular image, so let's just call this Paris. Okay, you got the idea. I can make this white if I want to make it stand out, I guess. I can bring it outline to it. Okay, you got the idea. Okay, now I wanna save this, it's not Canada, I wanna save it into the Paris folder. So now I'm gonna hit save as, and this time I'll call this Paris 1, okay? And now I'm gonna create another folder, and we'll call this Paris images, all right? And then I'm gonna hit save. And now when I come back to select my designs, I'm gonna have Paris images and Canada images. Okay, so Paris images here, and I'm gonna click it, and I'm gonna make the text yellow if I want to, all right? And then I'm gonna save as again, and we'll call this, of course, Paris 2, all right? But instead of naming something here, we're gonna go back to that folder, Paris images. So this is how to categorize your graphics, okay? Now, if you really wanna get into the mechanics of where the software is saved, you can go to your desktop. I'm on a Mac, but you can do this on Windows as well. Go to your desktop, and in your Documents folder on your computer, okay, you're gonna see Laughingbird Documents. That's where the images are all saved for the program. If you open it up, you're gonna see all of the graphics that come with the software that you might have purchased, but you're also gonna see a folder called My Designs. And when you open it up, there's my Canada images and my Paris images. And I'm gonna open that up. Here's Canada 1, 2, and 3. And my Paris images, I'm gonna have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, whatever, right? So that's how to categorize things. Now, don't name these folders manually on your desktop because the program will get confused, so don't touch it. Instead, try this. Let's go back here. Let's say I wanna move this Paris image into the Canada folders. So up here under File, you'll notice Select All and Deselect All, okay? There's a little check mark right here. If you click it, you can select this graphic, okay? Select All will select, if you have 200 logos in here or whatever, you can select all of them at once, deselect all of them. But if you'll notice too, when I click on one, a menu item pops up, Move Designs. I can move it, click it, and I'm gonna move it where? To my Canada images, all right? If you have six or seven different folder structures, you're gonna have a list. I just have one other one, Canada. So that's why I only see one here. Excuse me. Okay, so I'm gonna move it. It disappears from the Paris images and it appears in the Canada images, okay? So that's how you can structure things. Let's say I want only yellow graphics, okay? So let's go back, let's click on this one. And I'm gonna call this yellow graphic. And I'm gonna save this to another folder called yellow images, right? We'll call this yellow one and save it. And now I go back to my folder structure, my images here, and I'm gonna take all of my yellow graphics, this one and this one, and move them all into my yellow images, okay? So then I hit move designs, find yellow images, move them all, and now I have all my yellow images collected, I have my blue images collected, I have Paris images collected, okay? So that is a way to create a reflection and save your graphics. That keeps happening, by the way. We'll fix this, but if this happens and you see this, just go back to the color button and just click it. It'll snap. I don't know why yet, I'm gonna fix it, but that's just a little trick. Okay, so that's how to create a reflection and how to save your graphics into different compartments and categories so that you can organize things better. And I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. So watch this space next Tuesday for another Tutorial Tuesday using the Graphics Creator by Laughingbird Software. Thanks for watching.